Hi guys, welcome back to the channel for another video. So today I am with the Nissan Kicks, which is a mid-size SUV, and special thanks to Nova Nissan for allowing me to shoot this video. So the showroom details will be given in the description below, and also you can see right now running on the screen. If you want to go for any Nissan car or any Datsun car, and if you are from Jorhat, make sure you make an inquiry with the numbers given, as I won't be able to say anything about offers and all sort of things related. So moving forward, that is the car that I'll be reviewing today. It is the XV trim, which comes with the 1.3 liter turbo petrol engine, and I won't be giving a drive impression of the turbo variant, unfortunately, but I will drive the 1.5 liter naturally aspirated variant and tell you how the car feels out on the road. So without any further delay, let's now start the walk around, and then I will give the drive impression and tell you if the Nissan Kicks is still worth to buy over other mid-size SUVs like the Creta, Seltos, and all sort of options that you currently see out in the market. So let's get started. The Nissan Kicks is a mid-size SUV from Nissan, which was launched in 2019 to replace the Terrano SUV, which was a rebased Renault Duster or Dacia Duster. However, the Kicks, compared to other popular mid-size SUVs like the Creta and Seltos, is now a bit outdated in terms of some features, but I think it still has lots of wow factor which you won't see in other popular SUVs in this segment. When launched, it was the first SUV that came with options like 360 degree camera, most powerful turbo petrol engine option, connected car tech, and even remote key start, and that too with the manual transmission car. So in this video, I will show you in details about the nicest features that Nissan offers with the Kicks, and also not so nice things. I will also give the drive impression and tell you how it feels out on the road, and let you know honestly if it still has the Kicks compared to its rivals. So that's it, let's get started. So like always, starting with the keys, you will get two physical keys with this variant. This is the XV Turbo variant, and obviously one side in the key you can see the Nissan logo, and other side there are two buttons, lock and unlock button. And the Nissan Kicks is also offered with smart card type key for that keyless entry and exit. And with that key, in the XV Premium optional variant, the car can also be remotely started, and that too even in the manual turbo variant car, which was a great feature when it was launched way back in 2019. This car is fairly old now, but remote key start or remote start was first in segment at that time, so which was really a neat feature. Now coming to the front fascia of the car, here you can see the front fascia, Nissan grille, obviously the signature Nissan grille, and it's actually look like a Nissan car, not like the Magnite that gets like the Datsun type of grille. Here you can see that's the Magnite there, so here's the difference. Now coming to the front fascia of the car again, the grille, you can see chrome running across here, big Nissan badge here, then down under there you can see some skid plating. The approach angle of the car is really very good. It has a best in segment 210 mm of ground clearance, which is really a very neat feature. Now coming to the lights, obviously this is not the top spec variant, so it doesn't get that projector setup and halogen only light. You can also see in the headlight here, there is chrome line running across here, obviously dual chamber headlight as I've already told you, and also you can see neatly placed LED DRL here, but every other thing inside is halogen. The indicators are halogen, dual chamber headlight, but the actual bulb are halogen, even the fog lights down under there are halogen. So no LED setup in this car, even for the tail lights, those are all halogen. I'll go to the rear section, you can see, and even the LED DRL is incorporated inside a chrome line, and it really looks sharp from the front. As you can see, it really looks nice. Now talking about fog lights, they are down under there, the fog lights in this variant, the XV, it doesn't get a cornering function for the LED fog lights, but fog lights are there, obviously halogen. So the big grille here, they're really big, very big, which will help in cooling the engine. And talking about engine, this is the turbo variant. There are two variants or two engine options that Nissan offers with the Kicks. that is a 1.3 liter turbo petrol engine, which was when launched was segment best engine because that had 156 horsepower and 254 newton meters of torque, which was best in segment, most powerful engine, and it also shares the same engine with the new Renault Duster turbo petrol variant. And now that the XUV700 is out, the XUV700 has the most powerful engine in this segment, and that makes around 200 horsepower. And if you haven't seen my XUV700 drive impression and review, then check out the pop-up button there. Now the hood is designed nicely and there are not much big cuts and creases, and there are very few cuts and creases here. The paint, I don't think the camera is covering, but it has a not completely black, it is obviously metallic, so it has some sort of brown tint, and if I change my position I can see the brown tint here and there, like dark brown tint. Obviously big headlights already shown you, so there are two windshield washer dispensers, obviously large wipers. I'll check it out when I'll give the driving impression, I mean about the wipers. No auto dimming mirror I can see, no rain sensing wiper in this variant. And coming to the side of the car, this is the side profile of the car. Here you can see the side profile of the car. Obviously it doesn't get totally squared out wheel arches, these are actually rounded and not exactly rounded. When you see in person you will know it's kind of in the middle, squared and rounded. So the body cladding from the front, from front under there, runs across the whole body of the car. You can see whole body of the car, it runs across there. I'll come to the rear section in a bit. Let me tell about the side profile. So the side profile gets floating kind of roof treatment, but you cannot see that in a black colored car, obviously dark color car, and dual tone option and all, every sort of things are there. Up above there you can see roof rails, which are functional. Obviously these roof rails are functional, and the body cladding you can also see in there. The side skirts in this car is not visible actually, and there is a really very neat feature. I will show you that in a bit, and let me first talk about the A pillar, B pillar and all. The A pillars have a little quarter glass here, so it will help in reducing blind spots and all. It's a bit thick here, but as the quarter glass is here and the mirror is not actually placed up above in the door frame here or in the A pillar section, it's down here, so there will be very less visibility issue. And I will check it out when I will give the drive impression. Obviously body colored ORVM along with integrated side indicators, but this side indicator is not LED, it's actually halogen. There is also place here for camera, as this was the first in segment car to get 360 camera, but this variant doesn't get that camera. You have to opt for the XB premium optional for the 360 camera, and with that car you also get that smart car type key that helps you remotely start the car, as I've already mentioned you. So the door handles obviously body colored, no chrome treatment and all. And this section here, the design, you can see the door, how it's coming from here, like goes here and then it goes up here and all. So not very like symmetrical and all, but yeah, it looks okay because looks are always subjective. I really like how the Nissan has done or designed the kick. Yeah, it doesn't get any LEDs, light and those or projector sort of treatment that makes it outdated, but overall the design is still very fresh and new. It doesn't look like outdated at all. So again, coming to the wheels, large 17 inch alloy wheels, it's over 17 inch alloy wheels. The tire is from Apollo and the tire section is 215/60 R17. You can see, hopefully 215/60 R17 is the tire section. Really good size tire, and obviously the ground clearance, you can see 210 mm of ground clearance. Now coming to the doors, let me show you the side skirts for that I was talking about, how neatly Nissan has designed its doors. So this variant doesn't get any request sensor. I have to press the lock or unlock button in the remote, but the car is already unlocked, so I can pull it. Obviously no chrome door handles, body colored door handles. So there you can see the side skirt of the car, you see that. So this door actually goes all the way down, covers the side skirt of the car, and body cladding is obviously given, so it will save it from debris and all. And due to this feature, dirt and all won't go to the door sills, so it will protect the door sills, and a proper rubber sealing is done here so that dirt doesn't go inside or to this part. And as the car is a bit tall, you have to do some effort to go inside. That is the interior of the car. I will come to a bit, but as the car is a bit tall, you have to put the floor foot a bit above. Obviously no door scuff and all, or a door sill scuff and all, but as the doors are designed like this, it will not make your clothes dirty even if your pants and all touch this door sill area here. So really a very neat design, or great design, and this should be incorporated in every sort of other cars and all, because this will like keep your pants clean. So this design runs across the both the doors, like front and rear doors. The rear passengers pants and all will also be clean if you own a Nissan Kicks. Really neat feature. So that's everything on the side profile. Obviously this is the fuel filler cap here, not magnetically operated, but yeah, spring mechanism, and it holds 50 liters of fuel. Really a big tank. Again, talking about brakes, the front gets ventilated disc and the rear gets drum. So yeah, all-round disc is not available with this car. Traction control, hill hole assist, and every sort of things are available at the top spec variant, like ESP and all sorts of things, but in this variant it's not available. So ABS and EBD is actually standard nowadays, and obviously there are two airbags for the front passengers, dual airbags, no side curtain airbag, and as such in this variant, the top spec variant has options for those. So that's everything on this side profile. Now coming to the tail section, this is the rear profile of the car. Obviously no LED or as such I can see. LED is only in that high stop mount brake light here. Shark fin antenna there, obviously those are the roof rails. No spoiler, I cannot see any spoiler. The window is fairly large in the rear, or the rear windshield is large. Obviously there is defogger element, rear windshield washer, wiper, washer dispenser is here. So wraparound type tail lights are there, as you can see. And yeah, these are not LED, and these are actually halogen. The way it's designed, it looks like LED, but it's not. Here is the main rear running light, and obviously there is also a light part here that glows, and these are the side indicators. This is for the reverse gear light. Then badging, Nissan badging done here, Kicks badging here. This is place for the license plate holder, and obviously there is a reverse parking camera here, and again reflector there, reflector there, tow hook here. So four parking sensors are there, that is visible to me. 1, 2, 3, 4 in this variant. Then down under there, there is scuff plating. Obviously this is plastic, you cannot expect metal. Then this is the exhaust, which is a really very big exhaust, I can see. Then down under there is the, I don't think the spare wheel is full size, it's actually steel, and it will be around 16 inch spare wheel, and you have to access the spare wheel from down under the car. You cannot access it from the inside of the car. And yeah, because of that, the boot space or the loading lip will be flushed. I will show you that. So coming to this side again, same like the other side, obviously wraparound type tail light treatment and all. I'll turn on the lights and show you. Now there is request sensor here for opening the tailgate, so electronically holding actually. No, it's not electrically operated, but electronically holding. So there you can see the camera placed here, two LED lights for the license plate, and then there is the request button for opening the tailgate. So here is the boot of the car. Obviously the tailgate doesn't feel too much heavy, and there is a place to put your hand and close the tailgate, so it doesn't feel too much heavy. Anyone can open it. Two hydraulic struts are there. There is the parcel self, and this is the boot of the car, which is actually 400 liters. It's not that much wide, but it goes inside a bit. So yeah, plastic covering is here, some places here to put some different sort of stuff and all, I think some tools and every sort of thing. So light is placed there, hook here, carpeting is done very nicely. Obviously the rear boot is also accessible from the passenger side door, from the rear passenger seats, so it's accessible. You can see the parcel shelf. So let me fold it, I'll show it in details when I go into inside. So the boot, talking about boot, flushed, a little bit of hump is there, but it's not that much, it actually flushed. I really like this type of, like how the car makers do this, it should be flushed, because putting heavy luggages becomes really very easy. So some sort of hazard lights and all are there. So if I pull it up, so you can see how flat it is as the steering wheel is down under the body of the car. So fairly a good size boot, 400 liters. I won't say best in segment, but yeah, it's very deep, it will hold really very nice. And obviously the rear seats in this variant doesn't get 50-50 split seat, a completely folding bench seat. The top spec variants, I guess, will come with 50-50 split seat, and that's it on the rear of the car. Let's now go to the rear seats and tell you more about the comfort levels and all. Now opening the door, as I've already shown you, the door seal and all those things, like the rubber sealing is here, that will prevent it from, like while going in, it will prevent your clothes getting dirty, because that won't be going to this side, as there is a rubber sealing here and the door actually covers the whole side skirt. Now coming to the door, the windows seems fairly of average size, only this section actually opens and it's a bit high. Once I go inside, you will see how it feels or the point of view. Then chrome door handles, obviously power window button, then there is some carbon fiber finishing done here. This part here is actually fabric, soft touch material is there with nicely padded, it's nicely padded place to put your hand and close the door. Obviously speakers on each door, here you can see the speaker, 1 liter bottle holder, and little bit of space here for keeping some cloth or paperwork kind of stuff. So every single door gets power window in Kicks, obviously satin finish door handle. This really feels very luxurious to hold, and it's really very nicely designed. I really like the finishing here, satin finish should be given in like every sort of cars. The footboard there is not that flat, I can see two AC vents. Also there is a power socket here, and the light is obviously not LED, it's halogen. And obviously the seat is made of fabric, two adjustable headrest. The, as I have told you, the seat is not 60-40 split, it is a bench type seat, so it folds completely. And the parcel shelf can be, or the boot space can be accessed from the rear passenger seats. So here you can flip it, the parcel shelf, and you can access it. Really, really very neat feature. Obviously the middle passenger doesn't get a adjustable headrest, a teeny tiny headrest, as car makers think the middle passengers have a small head or no head at all. 3-point seat belts for both the passengers, Isofix child seat mounts are there, no 3-point seat belt for the middle passenger, a armrest which actually has two cup holders, no place to put your mobile phone or such thing. Let me just go inside and tell you more about the seating comfort and all. So let's close the door. So talking about the headroom first, the headroom is really very good, and obviously adjustable headrest, it's fairly comfortable. The reclining angle of the seat is also good, and this variant doesn't get a leatherette seat. For the leatherette seat, you have to go for the XV premium optional as higher trim levels, like those sort of trim levels where you will get fully leatherette interior, and you will also get a leather finished dashboard, which was first in this segment, like soft touch material on the dashboard in this like middle or mid-size SUV segment. And again, talking about the knee room, lots of knee room, as you can see. Obviously the seat is moved forward, even then if scooped out seat back of the front seat, I cannot see any pockets here, but obviously top spec variant will come with pockets. AC vents, already shown you, armrest for the front, passenger. No, this is not openable or cannot be open, and there is no storage in this here. And obviously talking about the under thigh support, for me the under thigh support is decent. It's good, actually not decent, it's good. And obviously the seat is fairly nice. The material I used is also nice in this car, in this variant. I can see fabric type material obviously, and it will like you will all obviously upgrade it if you get this variant for like leatherette type seat covers and all is obviously available. And stitching is done fairly nicely. The interior liner is not that great. You can see it's of mesh type material. I don't really like this finishing. It is prone to dirt very easily. Then grab rail here, grab rail for actually all the passenger, no grab rail for the driver, as he doesn't need that, he or she doesn't need that. No hook for coat hook and all, so I cannot see any coat hook. The window, as I already told you, only this section opens, and it's a bit little bit on the higher side, the for the rear passenger. So I won't say people will be feeling claustrophobic, but yeah, it's a little bit narrow. This section doesn't open, this quarter glass here. Then the D pillar is a bit thick. Obviously the windshield is, or the rear windshield is really very slanted, and you can see the defogger type element, it's there. Yeah, it's good. And obviously this car has a bit outdated now. Obviously no sunroof like its competitors or rivals, and Nissan should work in updating this car now, because sunroof and all are there in its rivals. Like at this price point, like top spec car, it will be around 17 to 18 lakh for this Kicks. So obviously again, like the other door speaker there. And that's it on the rear sitting comfort and all. It's good, it's not, I won't say it's like average and all, above average in this variant. And obviously let's now go to the front, and before going to the front, let me show you the dashboard design and all. So here is the dashboard design of the car, or the Kicks. You can see different sorts of material are used, and it looks fairly smart. Rounded AC vents, floating its 8-inch touchscreen infotainment system, analog digital instrument cluster there, 3-spoke steering wheel. Obviously this variant doesn't get steering mounted controls right on the steering, but I will show how the steering mounted controls are. Obviously 6-speed gearbox in this variant, armrest, handbrake and all. So let's now go to the front and show you the front interior in details. Now coming to the front doors. The front doors obviously doesn't get any request sensor in this variant, the top, or you have to go for the XB Premium for the request sensor and all those stuff. So no electronically opening outside mirrors, but there is some sort of blind spot monitoring as such. Like it's there, like some dots are there in this mirror. Hopefully you can see that. I'll check it out once I go inside. Now again, I've already shown you the door seals and all those things, I won't be talking about that. The front doors opens really very wide enough. The front doors are actually bigger than the rear doors. Again, satin finish door handles, more satin finish in this portion here. This is the button for electronically like adjusting the outside rear view mirror or wing mirrors. Auto touch function, auto up down function for the front driver side window, like front window. There is a little bit of quarter glass here for like decreasing the blind spot. Then lock button for, or child lock button for the window roll and up down. This material here, like the rear doors here, you can see is actually fabric, and it's padded really very nicely. So but no, it doesn't get, this variant doesn't get soft touch material. And the XB Premium optional in the door and in the dashboard, like in the middle portion, gets soft touch leatherette type finishing, which is really very good. And it also was the first in the segment when it was launched way back in 2019. So this car is right now is around 3 years old. So Nissan should really look into upgrading the car, looking into its rivals. Then place down under here is a speaker. Obviously the sound system in this car is really very good. I will show you how it sounds. Then bottle holder here, some more place to put some paperwork and stuff. So in that co-driver side door also same situation. And obviously the panel is fairly nice, of nice quality, and it doesn't feel plastic, like obviously hard plastic, but doesn't feel cheap. And obviously doesn't feel scratchy either, so it's not much scratchy. Leatherette type finishing is given. and this is actually the interior, front interior of the car, 3-point type steering wheel. I will show you in details, but before going inside, let me show you the pedal configuration and all those things. So hopefully you can see there are three pedals. So clutch, brake and accelerator. No, there is no dead pedal, like proper dead pedal here, as you can see, because the center console actually is moving outwards from here. So this is actually a big car, and Nissan should have incorporated the spacing here for putting a proper dead pedal, but yeah, it's not there. What can we do? It's not there. There is a little bit of area here to put your phone and stuff. Yes, you can actually put the phone here or even the keys, but like purse and coins and all sort of stuff will be keeping, like it will be convenient for keeping it here. Then there is a knob to open the hood of the car here, and there is a knob here for opening the fuel cap. Now talking about the driver side seat, it gets height adjustability, so 6-way adjustable driver side seat in the Kicks, which is actually really nice. Now there are some dummy button situation here. So the top spec variant comes with ESP and all traction control, all sorts of things, and headlight leveler switch is here. This is for actually the lights, like dimming for the brightness of the something. I can see brightness here. Then this is ideal start stop system. This car gets that. Obviously there is no start stop button in this car. There is a physical key, so a physical key situation is here. So coming inside to the Nissan Kicks, let me put the key here actually and put the seat a bit back. So the front driver seat is really very comfortable, good lumbar support. Considering the rear seats, the front seats are comfortable for both the driver and co-driver sides. Front seats are comfortable. As you can see, the lumbar support here is really very nice. It's well padded, and obviously fabric type material stitching is done really nicely. Then talking about headroom, you won't have any issue even if you are a shorter or taller person, as this driver side seat gets height adjustability. So 6-way adjustable front seat, obviously reclining and sliding adjustments are there. The seat is also not very narrow. The cushioning done is really very nice, well padded, comfort level top notch. The spacing in the footwell area not done very like conveniently. There is no dead pedal for the clutch operation or as such. Hopefully you can see no dead pedal there. Now this is the front dashboard of the car, front dashboard design of the car, as you can see. So analog to digital instrument cluster is there. So the A pillar is not that thick, and for reducing the blind spot there is a teeny tiny quarter glass here, obviously to that side also. So I can see a tweeter placed here, also a tweeter placed here, some vents for the AC and all. No rain sensing wiper, no auto headlight or auto dimming mirror or SS manual dimming mirror. Then again tweeter placed on the A pillar there and also on the dashboard there. Obviously the dashboard materials are hard plastic. This variant or trim level doesn't get soft touch material on the middle section here. The XV premium optional gets that. Then SRS airbag retained here. I really like how the AC vents are incorporated, satin finish here. Obviously middle AC vents are not round, there are two middle AC vents here. We'll talk about the floating type 18-inch sunscreen in a bit. Then again AC vents here. So the before talking about steering and all, let me show much more about the dashboard. So the dashboard here gets little bit of different finishing. The top spec variant, as I've already told you, comes with leather wrap dashboard, which was actually the first in segment. And again coming to the glove box is really very deep, and let me just show you the light and all. So here you can see light is placed. Obviously cool function is there. It's deep, but it's not wide or big enough like the Magnite, you can see. So Magnite video, if you want to see it, check out in the pop-up button somewhere here. It's there already. It's not good like UNC. It's an expensive car, so little bit of spacing could have been done for the glove box, but this is what you will get. Cool function glove box, obviously it's there. Nothing much special. Then obviously I've shown you how the material here is, and yeah, again you see the finishing, it's a little bit different, like hexagons, small hexagons are there. So again coming to the sunset and all, the sunset in the driver side gates mirror placed here, as you can see no lights here, but the lights here is directed towards the mirror, so the vanity mirror is done with this. Obviously front and rear all gets halogen lights or the interior lights, so there is no LED lights incorporated into this car. Obviously no sunglass holder or such, as I can see mic placed here, some more sensors and all are there. Then to the driver side again, vanity mirror is there in the sunset, and no light placed here, and again the light here or the map light here works as a vanity mirror light, it goes to this direction. Let's turn these lights off. Obviously if you turn it on, all the three lights will turn on, dome light, and there is a like notification area here for the seat belt reminder and all, like on and off you can turn off the front seat belt and as such things. So the sunset can also be pulled to this side, but see how useless the sunsets are when you pull to this side, as there is a large section here left out, so not much of a use if you put it to this side. But from the front it's fairly of nice size, so little bit of update should be done by Nissan. Then again the seat belts doesn't get any height adjustability in this variant, the Torso variant might get that, I don't exactly know, so I cannot say that right now. So 3-point type seat belts obviously. Then there is a armrest here, teeny tiny armrest. Obviously this is not leather wrap, leather wrap could have been given, it will actually get dirty if you don't get it wrapped with nice soft touch material, but it's fabric. The cushioning is done fairly nicely and it cannot slide it, neither you can open it to access anything or such things. So stitching done here really nicely, obviously manual handbrake, no leather wrap handbrake here. Then this is the 6-speed gear lever for the 6-speed gearbox. Obviously for reversing it the car, you have to pull the knob and put it like this, so there goes the reverse. I will see how the camera or the screen resolution is, I will show you that. So this is the center console area here and it's really very deep. Let me just turn on the light. As you can see it's very deep, no ambient light in this variant, you will get it as option. And I put the keys here, so no actual cup holders in the front in this variant, which is actually surprising. And no pull function or as such, a very large box is there, like deep section is there where you can put your phone and all, so no cup holders, which is surprising in a car like this, so really very disappointed with that. So these are the AC controls here actually, and there is a nice satin finish surround around the AC controls here. Also there is satin finishing here, and the center console doesn't get any cup holders or SS, which is really very disappointing. Then there is a hazard light switch here, also there is a lock and unlock or the central lock button is there, so like this you can lock and also you can unlock. So talking about the AC controls, really very nice AC controls, it really feels nice to hold because actual knobs are given, no like display and all is given, but there are little LED position lights which actually shows how the blower or the is working actually. Obviously then here is the AC on and off button, then there are actual buttons for like wind direction and all, so you can turn both these on for the direction, like moving to the face and also like blowing towards the feet and all. And also there is the defogger here, and front defogger max switch and rear defogger, front rear defogger, everything is there. Auto AC is there, so you can see auto AC is there, and this is actually for controlling the temperature here. You can see the light actually goes around the temperature, so let's put it into the minimal setting or minimum temperature. So fairly simple AC, no dual zone function or as such. Now coming to the steering wheel is not leather wrapped, obviously no flat bottom steering wheel, 3-spoke steering wheel, little bit of satin finishing is done. Then there is the Nissan logo, horn is placed here, no multifunction steering wheel buttons are not here, but the steering mounted controls are actually moved to this side of the steering wheel, I will come to it in a bit. The steering actually gets tilt adjustability, so there is a knob here, so you can see it's actually tilt adjustability is there, but no telescopic adjustability. Okay, it will work actually because you can move the seat for that, for the reach and all. And obviously, let's now talk about the controls here. So here are the steering mounted controls. My camera is not actually covering it like the way it's placed, but it's actually very easy to control from here. Like you, it's really very easy to reach from the steering wheel. But this here really looks odd how it's incorporated. This could have been given here, but yeah, you cannot actually see. You have to like guess it and know, like you have to do a little bit of practice is needed to access these buttons and all. So there is the volume button, up button here, so volume down button here. So steering mounted control, even though it's not there, it's actually works. Like you can see I'm increasing the volume. Obviously I'll come to the steering because it gets the steering or volume control knob here, which I actually love it. But steering mounted controls are there for like you to pull it towards you, so it will change that. Also voice command feature is there here, so from the top you have to press buttons here for voice command access and all, and this actually controls the steering here. So if I keep pressing it here, the steering menus changes. So here you can see it changes. That's it. That's how you change the volumes. And so that are the steering mounted controls for this screen. Now the controls for the headlight is actually to the left side here, so indicators and all and even the fog lights and all can be accessed from here. You can see no auto light function in this variant, and the washer or the washer wiper controls are to the right side actually. So new people who are actually like familiar with the headlight stocks on the right side and wiper stocks on the left side will have little bit of problem for the first time, but with like using the car, they will be comfortable, pretty comfortable with time. Now coming to the instrument console, this is the digital analog instrument console. As you can see, there are two MIDs that I can see, and to the left side there is the analog tachometer, to the right side there is the fuel meter. Actually this is not the speedometer, speedometer is in here. Then lots of telltale lights. Let me just turn the key on and show you more in details. Let's turn on. So there you see no swiping thing or as such, but there are lots of telltale lights. You can see check engine light, fuel filler light, door opens and button, or sorry, the handbrake and all. So middle here you can see the speedometer, then there is also MID here. So this car doesn't have any traction control or as such thing, so it won't show it in the MID here, and also doesn't get tire pressure monitoring and as such. For that you have to go for the like higher variant. So start stop deactivated, as you can see it's showing there. And if I press the button for actually accessing that, you have to press it here to the driver side, it's there. And if I press the button there, it shows a start stop button there. And for navigating through different menus for this MID, the button is not actually here in the instrument console, neither it's here on the steering wheel, and rather it's there in a very different, or I haven't seen in any other cars like this, but Nissan has incorporated it into the windshield washer wiper to the right side here to the stock. So if I press the button there, the MID shows different sorts of information. Like now it's showing average kilometer per hour, then service intervals, then obviously outside temperature is also showing, and again battery low, start engine, all sorts of things, the total odometer, then total fuel used, then again average fuel economy. It's really very showing very bad. Now current, as the current is, the car is like not started, so it's not showing anything. Then total range, like distance to empty and all. Obviously these sorts of things are shown. No, this car doesn't get traction control, as I already mentioned, no tire pressure monitoring system, so those sorts of things are not shown. Fairly simple in digital instrument console setup. I really like the fact that the tachometer is analog. The speedometer could also have been analog instead of giving the fuel filler or the fuel meter to the right side. Like a big size fuel meter, the fuel meter could have been given in the digital portion here. Speedometer could have been given to the right side. It would look really very nice. And obviously I love analog meters because they doesn't like age very fast. You can see like nowadays cars gets all those big screens and all, but trust me, within 1 or 2 years those features will really, like the screen will really get outdated, and it will feel like you are using a smartphone, like you change smartphone every 1 year or as such. So with digital screens. That is the problem if it's incorporated for the instrument cluster sensors. And that is my personal feeling. I prefer analog meters over digital, but Mercedes MBUX system, those are like really very good quality displays. I won't say about that, but even then, digital displays tend to itch very fast. So that's everything on the instrument console and all. Let's now get to the floating 8-inch touchscreen here and show you more in details. First of all, I really like how it's incorporated. There is a satin finish chrome line running across the whole screen, which really looks nice, and there are actual knobs here. I love this fact that there are actual knobs, and these knobs also get luxurious knurl type finishing. I really love that, obviously to this side also for scrolling through different menus and all. So it really looks really very nice and feels really good to hold. These are actual aluminium type knobs, and it feels like really metal is given. Display different menus or scrolling through menus, you can like press button, so actual physical buttons are there. This is also a very neat feature. More cars should do this, or car makers should give this type of displays actually, instead of rather giving like a slapping like a touchscreen, full touchscreen to there, and leave it like a phone, like phone controls. Even phone gets volume rocker button on this side. So screens in the car should get actual knob like this. The screen resolution is really very good, not that bad. It's actually nice, and again, lots of customization is there, like audio and all, Bluetooth and all, every sort of things like shortcuts, how you want to see, like USB and all, you can change it from here. So obviously auxiliary and all sorts of things are there. Android and Apple CarPlay is standard in this screen, and also there is Park Assist and all those features. So if I go through the menu here, the touch response is really nice. The resolution is also good, not bad. And if I press the camera, so this variant doesn't get 360 camera, but yeah, it gets reverse parking camera. And obviously you can increase the brightness or as such, obviously contrast in color, every sort of things are there. And with the 360 camera, the whole car or the top view of the car, like bird view, can be seen. And that feature was actually that first in segment feature. And for scrolling through different audios and all, there is also a knob here, also button here. Really a nice and neat screen, I have to say. Now let's put the car into reverse and see if the car gets reverse like adaptive guidelines or not. So this is the reverse parking camera view. It's actually really wide, and the screen resolution is also good. No, it doesn't get any adaptive guidelines or as such. Now let me show you how the music system in this car sound. And again, for your information, its doors get speakers in this car, and obviously there are two more tweeters in the dashboard and also on the A pillar there, and to this side also. Now before connecting or showing you how the music system sound, I want to say few more things about the system. Is that like there is setting how you want the speakers or the music system to sound. So sound setting is there, like different sorts of adjustment for equalizer sort of thing is given, so bass enhancer and all sorts of things are there. Fairly a very simple like interface is given. I really like how the screen is incorporated, or how the system is incorporated by Nissan. So without any further delay or talking much, let me show you how the music system in this car sounds. Let's listen it. Obviously screen mounted control is there, but that is a knob which I actually love. And also there are steering mounted controls to this side, as you have seen. Also increase the volume in my volume. So that was the music system of the Nissan Kicks in the XV variant. I really love it, how the sound or the sound quality is really very awesome sound quality. Good amount of bass, obviously you've seen bass enhancer and all sort of things are there. And I personally, inside the car, I just loved it how the music system is incorporated by Nissan. Obviously, Nissan cars have good sound qualities, like for the music system you have also seen in the Magnite and all. So you tell how you like it in the comment section below. Did you like the sound system or not? So that's it, that's everything on the interior of the Nissan Kicks. Let me just pop out the hood now and show you the engine and talk a bit about the engine details. So this is the engine bay of the Nissan Kicks. The hood is actually heavy, no hydraulic studs are not given, a simple stick is there. The hood also gets insulation. I forgot to tell you about the panel quality and all. The panel quality in this car is actually good. Not much flex can be seen. Obviously, due to the design of the car and all sorts of things, the safety rating may change. But even then, this car is really very good in this class. Lots of good features are there, like big wheels and all. Now, talking about the engine compartment alone, obviously, insulation in the hood so that the engine noise doesn't go out. Also, insulation in the firewall. And this engine here is the 1.3 liter turbo petrol engine, which was best in the class or segment in terms of power output back in 2019. And back in that day and still now also, it makes 156 horsepower from a 1.3 liter engine, obviously four cylinder. The power output is 156 horsepower and torque is 256 newton meters of torque. And the torque delivery was really at lower at the rev range, like around 1600 rpm. So the torque curve is around the whole rev range. So this car was really a beast to drive. But unfortunately, I won't be able to drive this or give you the dynamics of the Kicks with the turbo petrol engine. I will be driving the other engine variant option, like the 1.5 liter naturally aspirated engine that makes 105 horsepower and also gets that 5-speed manual gearbox. And this turbo petrol engine is also shared with the Renault Duster, so I'll be giving the drive impression of the Duster in my channel very soon. So if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, make sure you do so that you get notified when I upload the drive impression of the Duster. So that's it on the engine, about the exterior and interior details of the Nissan Kicks. Without any further delay, let's just go for the drive impression. So right now, driving the Nissan Kicks midsize SUV. Obviously, as I've told you, I am right now driving the XV 1.5 liter naturally aspirated version that comes with the naturally aspirated four cylinder engine. Obviously, this engine makes 105 horsepower. And first of all, talking about driving experience, the steering doesn't get any leather wrap treatment, but still the steering is fairly comfortable to hold. It's thick, so I'm feeling really comfortable in my hand to hold the steering wheel. Obviously, the horn is placed here. And talking about visibility, the visibility of the car is really very nice, as there is a small quarters glass here. There is very less blind spot in this area. The outside rear view mirrors offer really very nice viewing angles. The inside rear view mirror is not like auto dimming function, doesn't have auto dimming function, but has really nice viewing angles. I can really see the rear of the car, like the road out there. And the digital analog instrument cluster works really fine. Direct sunlight is falling. Even then, it's really very visible. That's the fact I love the analog instrument clusters. And talking about steering, again, the steering feedback is really nice in this car, like the Kicks. Obviously, it's a much premium car, so the feedback is really good. It's light at lower speed, and at higher speed, it gets heavy, and the feedback that it offers is really nice. I have full control that, and the direction changes are also very quick. It's not lethargic or slow, so it's lovely. And talking about the clutch feel and all, the clutch is fairly light and gear changes are also slick. The gearbox is good in this car. Obviously, 5-speed manual gearbox, 6-speed is offered with the turbo petrol variant, or the turbo petrol engine that makes 156 horsepower and 256 newton meters of torque. Only with that variant the 6-speed gearbox is offered. The brakes really very nice. And this engine, even though it produces only 105 or 6 horsepower, it pulls really nicely, so you have to maintain that rev range. And the torque output of this engine is really good. It's around 156 newton meters of torque, and the torque output is after like 2000 rpm. You have to maintain the rev range to keep it pulling at, like, whenever you want to tap the floor or want to floor it, it won't be pulling like in an instant like the turbo petrol engine does, so you have to maintain the rev range. I hope you can understand what I am saying. And talking about the ride quality is really very nice. The car is tuned very nicely, like the suspensions are nicely tuned. Obviously this car comes with 16 or runs with 17 inch alloy wheel, so bumps cannot be felt. And as you can see, I am at around top gear, and obviously the brake performance is really very good. The bumps cannot be felt that much. The ride is really very plush. There is not much bad patches around here to show you, but even then the road, the highway is not that even, but bumps are not felt. NVH level, now talking about NVH level, tire noise cannot be heard very much. People will be comfortable inside this cabin. Engine noise, little bit of it is like audible to the ears, but it won't be much of an issue. I personally love engine noise of a car, and it's a naturally aspirated engine, so it's really very good and it's pleasing to the ear. Actually it's not like unpleasant kind of noise. So NVH levels and all are really very nice. And unfortunately I couldn't tell you how the kicks with the turbo petrol engine felt, and for that I will actually drive the Renault Duster, because Renault Duster actually shares the same turbo petrol engine with the kick, and you will get to know how it performs. So obviously it will be, the performance will be similar, so nothing much more of a difference you will feel. And to see when I upload the driving video or driving impression of the Renault Duster, make sure you subscribe to my channel and also press the bell notification icon so that you get notified whenever I upload a new video to this channel. Talking about the overall cabin feel, the Nissan Kicks has a really plush ride and the suspensions are tuned very nicely. Obviously it runs on larger 17 inch wheels, so bumps cannot be felt very much. Also the NVH levels are very well maintained, and with a plush ride it's very comfortable inside the cabin. Yes, it may be outdated, like there are no sunroof on offer like its rival, but with a turbo engine on offer and a nice comfortable ride, the Nissan Kicks is still worth every penny. And that's it for today. That was my drive impression of the Nissan Kicks, and make sure you like the video. Also don't forget to subscribe, share this video with your friends and family. So that's it for today. Bye.